WTNH, Channel 8. Live from Connecticut's news station, this is Action News at 5:30 with Harry Martin, Diane Smith, and Nancy Aborn with weather.
Good evening, I'm Jon Crane. Tonight, Action News at 5:30 is live on the road here at the Volvo Tennis Tournament. And tonight we're going to be discussing how this tourney is now virtually devoid of any big-name players. And I'll be introducing you to one of the no-name people out here who makes things run at the Volvo. Right now, let's serve it off to Diane Smith. Di?
Thank you, John. Off right and left, and Jon Crane has been looking into all of that. He's over at the stadium court. Jon, what do you make out of all of this?
Well, no one's happy about it, Diane. You know, we knew anything was possible, and anything has happened. Who would have thought at this stage in the tournament, only two of the top 10 seeded players would still be in the action? Well, no one thought it. Disappointing? You bet. Devastating for the Volvo? Not likely. The weekend is still sold out, and from what I saw out here today, people are still pretty enthusiastic. The big names are not necessarily the name of the game. The play goes on, and the fans are still turning out strong despite what's happened. Sure, this is upsetting, no pun intended. Tim Mayotte, Michael Chang, Yvonne Lendl, and more, all losers.
In our case, we're knocking them off left and right. It's like a shooting gallery.
But tournament director Jim Westall doesn't feel as if he's now shooting blanks. On the contrary, controlling the fate of top seeds is not in his bag of tricks.
Certainly, I can't be standing under the seed tree with a big bushel basket catching them as they fall, and then when everybody goes home at night, put them back in the tree.
UPI sports writer Fred Waterman has covered 8 Volvos in all. He's seen this sort of thing happen before. His advice? Don't worry.
You can have a tournament where people say, geez, I don't know their names, but they keep coming back and going, I saw some great tennis today.
That's the face of a man who knows he's right. The big names are nice, but quality tennis is what people want to see.
I mean, I've seen some good players still today, like Gomez and Chesnikov, so it's still been good tennis, and it's nice to see people up close. So.
I'm for the underdog, I really am. I like to see a little variation, a little change. I think it's great. I don't mind it. I think it offers a lot of interest. A little more suspense.
It's the tennis. You know, I'd like to see the top seeds play, you know, if I could, but, you know, I came here to enjoy it anyway.
This guy is absolutely right. And, you know, it's also more than tennis. It's fun in the sun. It's food. This is also a social happening. And, Diane, for hardcore tennis fans, as yourself, as I know, there's one other thing you need to remember. Think back to the Volvo in 1986 up in Vermont. A lot of the big name, the top seed players, were knocked out early. A lot of them by one guy who ended up making it to the quarterfinals, 16-year-old Andre Agassi. Look what happened to him. So maybe this weekend out here at Stadium Court, another star will be born. Who knows?
Well, John, if that does happen, that next star may be standing with me right now.